just at this rest stop here, and I was going around here for no real reason, and I just found this little Carolina anole. I think it's something like Anolis carolinensis. They're pretty cool. They got, he was brown when I first caught him, and then he turned green as he was biting me. He's still attached to my finger, but yeah, I'm gonna try to let him go and see if he'll get off. Off, buddy. There he is. Now he's hopping around. He went in there. All right, cool. Eastern fence lizard here. My dad flipped it under a railroad tie over here on this random abandoned lot. I'm not sure if we're supposed to be here or not, but I don't know. No signs said otherwise, so awesome. Eastern fence lizard. Something cool that you could do with these guys is if you flip them over and tickle their belly, they'll kind of fall asleep and just stay there in your hand like that until you flip them back over. They'll come back too, but pretty cool. We're at this abandoned lot here. I don't know if we're supposed to be here or not, but we said whatever and we went and started flipping anyway. Underneath the carpet, we got this southern black racer here, Colubra constrictor priapus. He's eyeing me down pretty good. He's not too happy with me. I've got a little bit of blood on my hands. He bit me quite a few times, but he seems to be pretty chill now. But yeah, beautiful snake. Found these before Snake Road and stuff, but yeah, I'll tell you if I find anything else, and until then, see you later. Does not want to leave. Next to mine. Here he goes. Got a hollow heart. Let him explore a little bit. Ooh. Got a dollar in my pocket for midnight. Black Widow. Pretty cool. This isn't really a snake or what we were looking for, but see that red right there? She looks not very happy. I don't plan on handling her. Hey guys, we're just cruising down this road here in North Florida, and we just got this dusky pygmy rattlesnake, Cistrurus miliaris, I believe. If not, I'll put a little thing right here. But beautiful creature. This is the thing that I was hoping to find the most on this trip, and we just happened to find it on the second night, so incredible. We just got here yesterday. We just decided to be good to cruise, and we checked out a flip site, got a racer, found a DOR cotton. It was dead on the road, and we got ran over. Yeah, incredible snake. They're just super beautiful. People often call these guys the ground rattler. Because they're commonly found on the ground, they don't really climb, nor do really any other rattlesnakes, but they just call these guys that for some reason. They camouflage real well into their surroundings. You probably can't see it, but behind us is some pine woods habitat, and they blend in real well. They're like little landmines. This is responsible for the most bites of venomous snakes in the southeast every year. This and the copperhead, I believe, actually. And that's because they just blend in so well, people step on them. The thing is, they don't really deliver a fatal dosage. You probably won't die if you're a grown adult if you get bit by one of these, but they mean business a lot of the time. This one, super chill, not trying to bite or anything. Like I said, well, like I always say, they don't want to hurt you, they just want to get away from you. When they're coiled up camouflage, that means they just want a meal. If there's anything, like a lizard that walks by, they'll lure it in with their caudal lure on the back of their tail. I'll show you that. It's a little yellow tip. They use that to lure in lizards and mice and such. But, oh, here's a car coming. They use the little lure to lure in mice and such. This is a baby. He's very, very small, but beautiful snake. Well, I'll tell you if I find anything else, and until then, I'll see you later. So hey guys, right in this thing right here, we were just flipping some garbage. We found two Mediterranean geckos. I'm gonna try to take them out. I'm not collecting them. Even if I did, they're invasive, so yeah, I'll try to get one of them out at least. I got a little baby. Oh, here. So we got the adult in there. I'll show you him in a second. But here's the little baby. See if I can focus this. Alright, yeah, so here's a little Mediterranean, is that focused? Yeah, that's focused. Little Mediterranean gecko here. It's in the Hemidactylus genus, so I'm not sure what the specific species is. Yeah, here he is. Here's his back markings. I don't know if this is completely in focus. If not, I'm sorry. But, yeah, cool little guy, and we'll see if we can find anything else. Here's the bigger one. Pretty cool. Hey guys, just found this little eastern garter snake, Thamnophis sertalis. He's sitting here in the middle of this road. Pretty cool guy. The ones in North Florida seem to be a bit more checkered than usual, but cool. I guess I'm just gonna take some pictures and let this guy go. Found this real interesting looking eastern garter snake, another one. This is probably about 5 minutes after the last one. Real pretty blue on the sides and a nice checkered as well. Super cool looking. You don't get ones like this back in Chicago, so. Beautiful little garter snake. I'm just gonna release him right now. There he goes. Hey guys, just found this little eastern ribbon snake, Thamnophis sertalis, on this road here. He's a real small, here's my finger in comparison. But real thin, thinner than a pencil. I'm gonna release him off to the side of the road here, and hopefully he won't go back in and get ran over. Goes. Hopefully we'll be able to find some more stuff other than Thamnophis. Oh, Hey guys, we're just cruising this road down here, and we found this corn snake, this red rat snake. A lot of people call them that too. But this is the corn snake, Pantherophis guttatus, and like I've said in the past in my other videos, this is a really beautiful snake. They got really nice reds, oranges, browns. People call them corn snakes because one speculation is that they're found in cornfields, another speculation is that the bottom looks like Indian corn. But yeah, incredible snake, Pantherophis guttatus, red rat snake or corn snake, whatever you want to call it, and super beautiful snake, and hopefully we'll be able to find some more stuff out here cruising it down this road. So alright, I'll tell you if I find anything else, and until then, see you later. Hey guys, I just found this barking tree frog here on the road. It started raining and it's still raining, but yeah, this is actually a lifer for me. Really beautiful frog, and yeah, we're just gonna see if we can find anything else. Hey guys, just found this little southeastern mud turtle, if he can pop out his head for us here. But Kinosternon subrurum, I believe. If I'm wrong, I'll put a little caption there. But yeah, super cool. This is a lifer for me. The thing that you could differentiate these guys from the musk turtle is because they have a more developed plastron, which is the bottom of their shell. This one looks to be a female since she has a flat plastron rather than a curved plastron like a male would. But yeah, super cool, and hopefully we're going to find some other stuff. It started raining, and we started seeing a lot of DOR aquatic stuff, and we were just able to find this guy in time so that he didn't get ran over. So super cool, and we're going to see if we can find anything else.